Okay, here we go. In this sequence of videos, you are going to learn how to design programs. This is the first video, and my son has now heard me record it about 17 times. He's probably getting pretty bored. But he's also probably getting to know the pieces of the DrRacket interface, which is what I'm trying to show to you right now. So what you're seeing right now on your screen after starting up DrRacket is probably something like this, and I'm hoping that you can get this far, that is to say, can start up DrRacket without my help, because it's going to be different on every operating system. Once you do, your screen is going to look a whole lot like this, with the possible exception of this language level down here, which needs to be set to beginning student. In order to do that, you're going to go up to the language menu, which is just out of your frame, and choose language. And then you're going to make sure that beginning student is highlighted here. And then you're going to click on OK. After that, what you're going to see is pretty much exactly this. We'll go ahead and click on run. And now your screen really should look exactly like mine. OK, let's write a program. The first program that we're going to write is a simple one. But where does it go? Where do we put that program? This screen is divided into two windows. The top one is called the definitions window, and the bottom one is called the interactions window. And the definitions window is so called because it's where the definitions of your program go. In particular, the program that you're writing is going to go up here in the definitions window. So let's go ahead and write a program up here. It's going to be a very simple one. It's going to be the number 7. All right. Let's go ahead and run this program by clicking the run button. When we do, what we'll see is a result appears down here, to wit, the number 7. That is to say, the result of evaluating the program 7 is the result 7. There's nothing terribly earth-shaking about that. We can make a longer program if we like by adding a 23. When we run this program, what we'll see is that we get 7 and 23. These programs are both very simple programs. The results that they produce are precisely the same as the program itself. So to be fair, we're not really doing much in the way of computation. However, we have written a program. Down here in the interactions window, we can also run programs. We can type, for instance, 78. When we run this, the result is 78. Now, the last thing I want to do is to run this program one more time. And when I do, I want you to think about what's going to happen to the definitions window and what's going to happen to the interactions window. Okay, so think about it for a second, would you? Okay, let's try running it. Is that what you expected? Okay, the interactions window disappeared. Right? The definitions window did not. Okay. That's why we're going to write our programs up here. And we're not going to do too much down here because the stuff down here is going to get erased every time we run. Just to finish this off, let's go ahead and save our program. We'll call it abc.racket. Go ahead, save it. And now we are done.